गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वर्कशीट 13 डेट 3820. द टॉपिक ऑफ वर्कशीट इज फ्रॉम द चैप्टर एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो हियर इन दिस वर्कशीट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द डाल्टन एटॉमिक थ्योरी टुडे. जिज्ञासा दीदी, इफ द साइज ऑफ एन एटम इज सो स्मॉल एंड इनसिग्निफिकेंट देन वी कैन नॉट सी देम, देन व्हाई शुड वी थिंक एंड केयर अबाउट देम. एज इन द प्रीवियस वर्कशीट we have discussed that the size of the atom is too small and we have to measure it in nanometer. So that's why this gyan is asking why such an insignificant and so small thing we are discussing, then how the she is replying. It's because everything around us is made of atom. The basic thing is that we cannot, being so small, we cannot ignore it, because everything is made up of atom. Though we are not able to see it, but still it's constantly affecting whatever we do, because every matter is made up of atom. So that's why we have to discuss it. There was a scientist named John Dalton who proved the basic theory about the nature of matter, and his theory was based on the law of chemical combinations, the two laws which we have studied, the mass and the constant number. So according to Dalton atomic theory, the matter, whether an element, compound, or mixture, is composed of small particles called atoms. So you have to remember this. The law of chemical combination was the base of this Dalton atomic theory. And what he said, whether an element, compound, or a mixture, all are composed of small atoms or particles which are known as atoms. So what were the main points of this Dalton atomic theory? First point, all matter, whether solid, liquid, gas, they are made up of tiny particle called atoms, and these atoms are the basic unit of matter that participate in a chemical reaction. That means when we are doing in a chemical reaction, it is the atom which is doing the reaction, which is helping in the formation of bonding, whether it is ionic bond or other bonds. So it is the basic unit, like cell is called the basic unit. Likewise, in a matter, atom is the basic unit. Second point is, atoms are indivisible particles. That means we cannot divide it further as per the Dalton atomic theory. While after the further studies, we will study about the subatomic particles. But here, according to Dalton, this atom was indivisible particle which cannot be created, destroyed in by a chemical reaction. Third point are, atom of a given element or compound are identical in shape, mass, and chemical properties. Like that, if we are talking of in a hydrogen, so in the hydrogen, any number of atoms will be there. They will be of identical in size, mass, and chemical properties. Fourth point, atoms of different elements have different masses and chemical properties. If we compare atom of hydrogen with atom of sodium, that means that atoms of hydrogen will be different in the mass and chemical properties with the atom of sodium. Fifth point is, atoms combine in fixed ratio as small whole numbers to form compounds. Likewise, we have studied constant proportion, law of constant proportion, that if water molecule is to be formed from hydrogen and oxygen, then two hydrogen and one oxygen has to combine. So atoms combine in fixed ratio of small whole numbers to form compound. And the sixth one is, the relative number of kind of atoms are constant in a given compound. So any compound which is formed will have the fixed number of this atoms. The relative number will be fixed. So all these points you have to remember. Now we come to the question answers. First question, all matter is made up of very tiny particle called atoms. Then, atoms are the basic unit of matter that participate in chemical reaction. Then, Dalton atomic theory was based on the law of chemical combinations. Then, in a chemical reaction, atom can neither be created and nor be destroyed. Any three postulates of Dalton theory with example. So when you have to explain any three postulates, you can take any three like atoms are individual particle which cannot be created destroyed by chemical reaction. You can take the example like that, if you are combining hydrogen oxygen, it will be giving water. So the formation of atom is there, that means on the reactant side we are having hydrogen, on the product side also we are having hydrogen, no new thing is formed. Then atoms of a given of different elements have different masses and chemical properties. Different masses and chemical properties, as I said, that if we have to compare hydrogen with sodium, atoms of hydrogen will be having different properties, atoms of sodium will be having different properties. And third postulate, you can take that atoms combine in a fixed ratio of small whole numbers to form compounds. Again, you can take the example of water, ammonia, any other compounds in which the number of atoms of a particular element are fixed. So by this you can give the answers of these questions very easily. Thank you.